Hello there. Once again, this is Alex from the Jane team with another volume of In Case You Missed It, our monthly roundup of all the new and exciting features in Jane. As always, if you'd like to skip ahead to one of the features, you can use the chapters listed at the bottom of this video. Privacy and security are always at the top of mind at Jane. This is why we're happy to share that Jane has launched a new privacy preference that provides your clinic with a choice of how a client's financial documents can be emailed. To enable this setting, all we need to do is head into our settings, then into billing settings, and finally, check the box beside hide patient information from financial emails. Once a patient receives the email, they can click the link and Jane will ask them to sign into their existing account or create an account using the email listed on their patient profile. As part of our ongoing efforts on improving the US insurance experience, we've streamlined the process to record a $0 EOB in Jane. With the new functionality, we can enter a patient's responsibility directly from the insurer payment screen. If the insurer is left with no amount to pay, Jane will recognize this, push the amount to the patient, and then list the insurer invoice as no charge. Simple as that. You can then continue on to the rest of your invoices, all within the same screen. Have you ever asked yourself if you've already pulled a report or not? Or maybe you'd just like to check who else is taking a look? Well, we've made some improvements to the activity log so you can do exactly that. Head over to your Reports tab, scroll down to the Activity Log, and utilize the new Reports filter to see when a report has been viewed or exported by anyone at the clinic. We also hosted an Intake Forms webinar, which was our biggest webinar yet. Hosted by our very own Kiki and Mark from the support team, they delved deep into one of Jane's most useful features. Here's a short clip of Kiki explaining how you can use Intake Forms for more than just your initial visits.
So this is my favorite area of the intake form, just because I just love the ability to really customize and create unique forms for your practice. And so though we're often talking about intake forms as health history forms or even consent forms, you can use the intake form feature to create any, you know, sort of form that you might need to receive questions or responses to or consents for using the intake forms feature.
You can find a full recording of the webinar on the Jane App Clinic Software Facebook page, under the video section. Speaking of Facebook, I want to give a quick shout out to Jane's community Facebook page. This is an excellent place to connect with other peers using Jane and ask or answer any questions you might have. You can find the group by typing in jane.app community form into the Facebook search bar. Then answer a couple questions, read the rules, and your request to join the group will be sent. In no time, you'll be connected with thousands of other Jane users right at your fingertips. Alright, that is going to wrap up this edition of In Case You Missed It. If you'd like to take a deeper dive into any of these updates, we've listed guides for each below. I'll see you next month for another roundup of awesome features that you don't want to miss.